WhatsApp has recently made some updates that makes it easier to use WhatsApp on various different devices simultaneously. In this video, I will show you how to use WhatsApp on your tablet without a SIM card. My aim is to make this video as clear as possible so that everybody could use WhatsApp on their tablets again and again. So, let's get started.
Step number one, go to your tablet, and it doesn't matter what model tablet you got. Next step is to open a browser. Again, it doesn't matter what browser you're using, but it would be easier to follow these steps if you have got Google Chrome. So open Google Chrome or any other browser. I'm starting with a blank browser. Therefore, simply press the plus button to open a new tab. Here is the most important step of all. You need to touch the three dots in here to get additional options. And the most important thing to do in here is to check the desktop site. Now, go to the address bar and type in web.whatsapp.com. And then touch go. Be patient, it would take some time for it to load. Here, make sure keep me signed in is checked. Now you need to go to your WhatsApp on your phone and then go to the chats tab. Then select the three dots so that you could get more options. One of the differences is in its name. Now WhatsApp doesn't call the link devices option as WhatsApp web. Instead, it is called linked devices, which makes sense because we are not just linking the WhatsApp web, but we are linking more devices. Therefore, simply select linked devices. Then you should get an option called multi-device beta. If you don't see this option, don't panic because as the name says, it is in beta phase. That means it's not ready for everyone. But if you're one of the lucky ones, then simply select it. Here it will give you a description of what this multi-device beta is. The most important thing is if you try to message someone after joining the beta and they don't receive messages or calls, it might be because they don't have the latest WhatsApp installed on their phone. Therefore, if your message is not sent to someone, try another person and see whether it works. If you have read this message and you're happy, then simply select join beta. Then you will get this message saying if you have already linked your other devices, it would sign out and then you would have to link them again by scanning the QR code. So simply select continue. And now we have joined this beta update. As you can see, you still got the option to leave the beta. But I want to take advantage of this beta update and link my devices. So select back. And you can read here which says multi-device beta joined. Next step is to link a device. Select link a device. Then it might ask you to enter a password or use your fingerprints. Now get your phone and scan the QR code on your tablet. Then your WhatsApp web on your browser would start to connect with your WhatsApp and then organize all your messages so that you could start using your WhatsApp on your tablet. Now that we have connected, let's try to test WhatsApp web. So select one of your contacts. And now I'll simply type hi and press the send button. Now going to my friend's phone and opening WhatsApp on her phone, you can see that the message has been delivered. Now it's time to share a couple of tips so that you would always be able to use WhatsApp on your tablet. First, let's see what happens if you would close your browser. So let's close the browser and then reopen the browser. then WhatsApp will try to connect again, and it also makes sure end-to-end encryption is secure. Here it is, we were able to reconnect to our WhatsApp. Now I want to show you what happens if you turn off the desktop mode. Therefore, touch these three dots to get to the options for your browser. And then simply uncheck desktop site. As soon as you do that, the website changes from web.whatsapp.com to whatsapp.com, and now we have lost our connection to WhatsApp. So let's accept the cookies here because we got no other choice. Here it shows you an option to select WhatsApp web, and if you select it, nothing would happen because WhatsApp.com knows that you're using a tablet and would suggest you to install the WhatsApp app instead of going to WhatsApp web. Luckily, if you would go back to your browser options and then check again the desktop site while you're on WhatsApp.com, it will recognize that you've been connected to WhatsApp web before, and it will try to connect to WhatsApp web again. This is one of the major improvements in this latest update of WhatsApp, because if you were using the WhatsApp without this update, then even if you would check desktop mode, your WhatsApp would still not connect, and the only way you could connect it was to go to your cache and cookies and clear all your cache and cookies from the beginning of time. Again, to test how robust WhatsApp web is, we can try to refresh this page and see whether it still works. So when I press the refresh button, it starts reconnecting again to WhatsApp and it still works. And now let's see what happens if I close this tab and try to reopen WhatsApp. So close the tab and then touch the plus sign to open a new tab. Now go to the address bar and type web.whatsapp.com again and select it. And if you come to whatsapp.com instead of web.whatsapp.com, don't worry, you simply need to go to your browser's options and check again the desktop site, and as you can see, it starts reconnecting again to your WhatsApp, and you can continue using WhatsApp on your tablet. To make it easier to open WhatsApp again on our tablet, we need to bookmark this website. So, touch the star to bookmark this page. Now, if I want to get to WhatsApp again, I simply touch these three dots and then select bookmarks and then scroll down to wherever I saved my WhatsApp bookmark and then simply select my WhatsApp bookmark. As you can see, we managed to connect to WhatsApp again using our bookmark. Unfortunately, you can't make video or audio calls, but there are a lot of other things that you can do using WhatsApp web. For example, if you touch these three dots in here for one of your contacts, you can do almost everything that you can do on your WhatsApp app. And if you touch these three dots, we get even more options. For example, you can log out or get to the settings to access even more options. Now, if you go to your main phone and select these three dots, then select linked devices, you could get device status at the bottom in here. And then if you hold your finger on one of the devices, such as Google Chrome that we have just connected, you got an option to log out. So in this way, you can make sure that nobody else other than you is running your WhatsApp and can view your messages.
There are a few improvements that are worth mentioning. Now you can continue using WhatsApp on your tablet even if your phone is disconnected from the internet. Note, every 14 days, you would still need to connect the phone to the internet, otherwise your WhatsApp on your tablet would get logged out and you will have to link your tablet again. You could use additional four devices plus the main phone. You don't need to clear cache and cookies anymore. Just using your browser in the desktop mode is enough. Therefore, if you close your browser, you could easily access the WhatsApp web again. It takes longer to open WhatsApp web on the browser. This is because WhatsApp is securing the messages so that it will be end-to-end encrypted even when you're using WhatsApp web on a browser. Despite all these improvements, you still won't be able to make video or audio calls using WhatsApp web. Maybe that will come in the next update. To make WhatsApp video calls from tablets, you will need to transfer WhatsApp account from your phone to your tablet. To learn how to do it, please watch the video in the description. To learn more about WhatsApp, you could watch my other videos in here. In order to support my channel and learn about the latest WhatsApp updates, please don't forget to subscribe. And finally, if you have got any questions, please let me know in the comments below.